That day, we didn't know why she was arrested until the day, the first trial, when they gave us the list of charges. And the list of charges included several charges, contacting Human Rights Watch, contacting Amnesty International, applying for a job at the United Nations, contacting diplomats, contacting foreign journalists. These are the charges that she is facing. We thought she was being treated well at the beginning. We didn't know that she was subjected to torture, sexual harassment, and mistreatment, and solitary confinement until November of 2018. All this madness, we didn't know that was happening. You know, Frank, Lujain, you know what Lujain said to my parents the other day? She said, I wish if I can stay in jail forever, because what they did to me was horrific, and they destroyed my life. Like all sorts of torture, electrocutions, waterboarding, sexual harassment. And this is actually done by the Saud al-Qahtani, the top advisor of the Crown Prince. He was actually overseeing the torture at the secret facility, because when the torture was happening, that was happening at the secret facility outside Dahban prison, and it was done in a basement, and that where Saud al-Qahtani was overseeing the torture. He was laughing, he was you know, threatening her with rape and murder. Now the public prosecutor is denying the allegation of torture, and they are claiming that they have launched an investigation on that, and they have determined or concluded that there are no signs of torture, and that shows that there is no fairness and justice in that case.